My name is Aaron Gronstal, and I work for the Astrobiology Program Office at NASA. Let's see, my background's in geomicrobiology. I did kind of start with NASA as a scientist, and that kind of developed into other things. I've been drawing pretty much all my life. My mother is a visual artist. She does a lot of work in inks and watercolors, and was kind of just self-taught. And I did kind of joke that, like, I finished my PhD in geomicrobiology and then went back to being a 14-year-old in my pajamas drawing comics in my bedroom. Comic books were definitely kind of one of my dreams growing up. Astrobiology is the study of the origins of life on Earth and the potential for life elsewhere, and it includes a wide range of different disciplines and scientists and different scientific questions, and the graphic histories were just a good way to kind of gather all of those disciplines and those individuals together and present the content in a way that was more accessible to the general public, I think. Like, the idea is that you should be able to look at the page without any text and get a story out of it. And you should be able to look at the text and get a story out of it. And they're not necessarily, they're telling the same thing but from different angles. Sometimes without even realizing it, you're digesting the same information in two different ways at the same time, and it can be a really powerful teaching tool. Once the script is all together, I sit down and start the actual drawing, and I work in pencil and ink by hand. A lot of people work purely digitally, but I do, you know, pen on paper up through the inking stage. I work first in blue pencil, and then pencil on top of that, and then inking the pencils. By doing the blue pencil, you can kind of get the sketchy outline of things to begin with. But then once you scan, adjust the contrast and make those lines disappear, so then you can just pull out the ink work at the end. And then that goes in the computer and all the coloring takes place there. Once the layouts are complete, get all the kind of digital files together, and those go off to the printer, and then we start getting proofs from the printer and approving the actual final product. It's been really nice to kind of do this and have people appreciate it and enjoy being in it, and which is one reason, like, we go and get permissions from everybody. Like, I want the scientists to enjoy this. I want them to look at this and be like, ah, look, you know, there I am as a cartoon and that kind of thing. And it's great that it's gone over so well with the science community. And one of my favorite things with it as an outreach tool has been at the conferences where the scientists are present, and I encourage people that are picking them up, like, you should go around and get, you know, Dave Deamer to sign, and you should get... I think especially for some of the young career people, they've said that that's been actually a really good way to, like, go up and approach a scientist whose work they know, but they're kind of afraid to, like, go up and just, you know, talk to Vicky Meadows, even though Vicky's wonderful and she's really easy to talk to. But, like, going up with the comic and saying, hey, can you sign, you know, your image? And it's a talking point that doesn't necessarily come up in scientific fields all that often. Issue 7, which was kind of prebiotic chemistry and the origin of life. But that was released at AbiSciCon 2019, just this past June, and immediately started work on the next one. We're thinking biosignatures and life detection. Blue pencil on this is, like, really messy, but then once you get down to the ink, like, you don't see any of the blue. Start with the base image and then do kind of tracing paper over it and get the layering that way. Anthony Rapp came to AbiSciCon 2019 as the keynote speaker. Yeah, he was in Rent. And I grew up gay in small town Iowa. Like, Rent was kind of a big thing. It was great to meet him in person, shake his hand, and thank him for his work.
And what's that day like when you get that first printed copy you're holding in your hand? What's that like?
Terrifying. It's always hard because you get it. I mean, I'm one of those people that when I create something and and I have the finished product, the first thing I see is the things that I wish I'd done different. Like, it takes months, sometimes longer, for me to kind of look back, see it with fresh eyes, and be like, oh, it actually worked.